Hello friends, this is Supriya. Welcome back to my channel Biology Reader. Today's video is all about the protoplasm, and by the end of this video you will be able to know the definition, components, important terms, properties and functions of the protoplasm. So friends, let's get started. Let us start the video by defining the term protoplasm. Anything inside the cell membrane is considered the living matter of the cell or protoplasm. Protoplasm is a collective term used to indicate the combination of cytoplasm and nucleoplasm. The fluid material within the cytoplasmic membrane or cell membrane is known as cytoplasm, whereas a fluid substance within the nucleus is termed as the nucleoplasm. In this diagram, a blue dotted line indicates the portion of protoplasm. As we can see in this diagram, a prokaryotic cell lacks nucleus and some specialized organelles. So here the entire cytoplasm, excluding cell wall and cell membrane, is termed as the prokaryotic protoplasm. But eukaryotes have well-developed nucleus, specialized cell organelles. So here the entire cytoplasm, including the cell organelles and the nucleus, is termed as the eukaryotic protoplasm. Protoplasm is generally a fluid substance holding suspended macromolecules and some complex structures. Friends, we might get confused with the terms like protoplast, cytoplasm and nucleoplasm that are sometimes interchangeable with the term protoplasm. We will briefly discuss each term later in this video. Now, coming into the components of the protoplasm, it has two major divisions, that are cytoplasm and nucleus. Prokaryotes only comprise the cytoplasm, while eukaryotes comprise both cytoplasm and nucleus. Starting with cytoplasm, it contains membrane-bound organelles like mitochondria, Golgi bodies, etc. as the suspended structures. Besides that, the cytoplasm also carries dissolved matter in the form of enzymes, fatty acid, sugar, amino acid, etc. Cytoplasm exhibits three significant properties. First one is, a cytoplasm comprises watery or aqueous solution within all cells, which is called the cytosol. Then the cytoplasmic organelles of both the plant and animal cells can move because of the cytosol's fluid nature, and the process is called cytoplasmic streaming. Then the third point is, the cytoplasm is considered the living matter of the cell because of the movement of cytoplasmic materials as per the cytoplasmic reactions. A cell is considered dead if the organelles are metabolically inactive. Then coming into nucleus, it holds the chromatin material. Then it is the control unit of the cell that directs the cell growth, movement and metabolism. A fluid within the nucleus is called the nucleoplasm that holds the genetic material as well as the nucleolus. And a nuclear membrane surrounds the nucleoplasm and also comprises several pores to facilitate exchange between the cytoplasm and the nucleus. Now we will discuss few important terms that are relatable with the term protoplasm. First one is protoplast. Friends, we usually get confused with the terms protoplast and protoplasm. By looking into these two diagrams, we can say that protoplast is a combination of cell membrane, cytoplasm and nucleoplasm. Whereas a protoplasm is a combination of cytoplasm and nucleoplasm, excluding cell membrane and cell wall. Now here a question comes, that what is cytoplasm and what is nucleoplasm? So friends, cytoplasm is defined as a protoplasm without nucleus, and nucleoplasm is defined as a protoplasm embedded within the nucleus. Finally, cytosol is the aqueous fluid without cell organelles, and it contains smaller organic molecules like amino acids, glucose and other simple sugars. In addition, sodium, potassium and calcium ions are also present within the cell cytosol. Let us discuss some important properties of the protoplasm. The entire content within the cell membrane of a living cell is termed as the protoplasm. It is considered as the living matter of the cell because it includes cytoplasmic organelles, cytoplasmic inclusions and nucleus that participate in all living processes. We have already discussed that the protoplasm of eukaryotes comprises both cytoplasm and nucleoplasm. Conversely, prokaryotes lack nucleus and the protoplasm is entirely composed of the cell cytoplasm. A cell protoplasm of eukaryotes contains specialized cell organelles like mitochondria, Golgi bodies, endoplasmic reticulum, chloroplast, etc. Besides that, the protoplasm also contains polar substance like water, micromolecules like ions, inorganic salts, amino acids and monosaccharides. It also contains macromolecules like proteins, enzymes, lipids, nucleic acids and polysaccharides. We will end up this video by discussing three significant functions of the protoplasm. First one is compartmentalization. A protoplasm has various compartments like mitochondria, Golgi body, nucleus, endoplasmic reticulum, etc. Therefore, the protoplasm is compartmentalized into discrete cell organelles that separately perform specific cellular functions. Compartmentalization within the cell reduces non-specific interactions between the cells and increases cellular efficiency. Second one is cell growth and development. A protoplasm has two distinct regions that are cytoplasm and nucleoplasm. Cytoplasm is the site promoting cell expansion, growth and metabolic processes. And nucleoplasm contains the genetic material that regulate all the activities related to the cell growth and development. Each organelle within the cell plays a distinct role in the cell growth processes. For example, the mitochondria synthesize energy for multifarious metabolic pathways and chloroplasts are specialized to perform photosynthesis. Last one is protoplasmic movement. It is the mechanism in which the fluid substance of the cytoplasm moves within a plant or animal cell. This movement helps in transporting nutrients, proteins, and organelles within the cell. So friends, this is all for today. I hope you find this lesson useful. To know this topic more in detail, you can visit our official website, that is biologyreader.com. Link is provided in the description box. So friends, do like, comment, share and subscribe my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon for more videos.